So the MSc Environmental Assessment and Management, it's got a long history now. We've been running the program for 25 years or more, actually. So it started out in terms of getting trying to embed environmental considerations into decision making for as part of the sustainability agenda that was developing at that time. So that's kind of the origins of the programme, and hence we've built on from there.
This course in particular has a massive reputation. I'd used to talk to environmental consultants and people of that sort of nature, and they would always refer back to the reputation of this course and say that they've employed lots of people from this course.
Yeah, the sort of people that come onto the course, it's very varied actually, a real broad community. In terms of their backgrounds, it's very, very diverse. Environmental assessment, it's very multidisciplinary. You're looking at a huge range of different types of issues, and it's that holistic element that's important. So it's being a kind of a generalist is actually the emphasis.
I'm impressed in a good way, actually, because it's really practical and we actually learned a lot, and we learn how to do a concrete job.
The accessibility of the faculty was one of my prime choices when I came here, because I found that they were the most accessible of all the places I looked. They always have an open door policy, you can go see them if you have trouble.
We're very fortunate, and I think it reflects the culture of the university, that we're typically practitioners as well as being academics in our scope. So a great example of that is my colleague Ricky Terravel, who runs her own sustainability consultancy. So it brings all the issues that practitioners face on a day-to-day basis into the learning and the sessions that we undertake with the students.
Our tutors support us a lot. We have we can actually speak to them if we have an issue, whatever, and they are not just here to teach us, but also really to support us from everything else, and I really enjoyed that.
We're very conscious about making sure that our course is relevant to practice. It's absolutely at the core of what we do. I wouldn't be here if that wasn't the case. I'm not interested in research and abstract work for the sake of it. It needs to be applied. It needs to be useful to practitioners. So we engage practitioners to come in to provide inputs to some of our taught modules. It really brings that rich context, that rich case studies, and they're able to talk obviously about the challenges of delivering projects to clients' specifications, to working to tight budgets, to the sort of uncertainties that they have to handle on a day-to-day basis in delivering a successful project for their clients.
The facility at Brookes is unbelievable. Like, we've just had this beautiful building we're in now, massive new investment into the campus, which is meaning there's a lot of open space to work in. Like, there's all the equipment you'd need for your studies. It's just a lovely place to work.
It's one of the best cities to be a student, I guess, because, I mean, it's full of students everywhere, and students from all over the world, and everything is actually taught and made for students, and so I think it's definitely one of the best places.